Visit our fabulous sponsor, Caught Gold Jewelry, link in the description below. Hello, fabulous friends, fans, and superstars. Welcome to your horoscope for the week of March 3rd, 2019. I am your astrologer, Nadia Shaw. Thank you for being here. What an amazing week it is. We have an active sky, certainly, but it has this interesting contrast. On the one hand, we have this Neptunian, idealized, illusionary energy. And then on the other hand, we have an energy that is all about clarity and leaping into the future. One asks us to be compassionate and artistic. The other asks us to be rebellious and more technology oriented. But regardless of which energy you are accessing, well, chances are you will feel both playing out in different areas of life, certainly, because they both are powerful. So let's start with that energy of rebellion and revolution and clarity. It is, of course, Uranus. In the middle of the week, right around Wednesday, give or take a day on either side, depending on where you are on the planet, Uranus will change signs, moving back into the sign of Taurus. Now, if you remember, last year, in the middle of last year, we had a few months of this energy. And then Uranus retrograded back into the sign of Aries to sort of wrap up loose ends. And now, as we step into this new phase for us as humanity, for us as a collective, it is going to bring with it a awareness and a sense of bringing in elements of technology to all things Taurian. Now think back to what happened in the middle of last year. We had a few things that were particularly notable. But I think the biggest one that spoke most strongly to Uranus moving into the sign of Taurus, it had to do with cryptocurrencies, of course. This idea of bringing a different way of understanding money, a more evolved, yes, emerging of technologies and the ways in which we have exchanged currencies before, has gone through a massive shift, but we only just got a taste of it. And it is going to be now that we begin a 7-year journey as a collective in this matter and many others. Now, I did speak about this at length in the Uranus special horoscope, and I will be sure to link to it below. I did link to it in the monthly horoscopes as well. It is absolutely worth watching again, especially in the middle of this week. And it is also worth having some kind of a celebration, some sort of a party, if you will, in order to acknowledge that it is now going to be one area that Uranus is leaving in your individual sky that is going to start to feel a lot more calm, a lot more stable. All of us, again, in our own individual journeys, have gone through a process of understanding more deeply what it means to express ourselves authentically and to be ourselves fully and honestly in one area of life. And that work is done. We did what it was that we were meant to do, and we are changed forever as a result of Uranus moving through the sign of Aries. We are changed as a collective, certainly, but as individuals as well. And so now here we are, we embark on a new journey of understanding things differently than we did before, collectively, certainly, but also in a new area of our life, depending on our sign. Now, this can be your rising sign, your sun sign, or your moon sign, but regardless, there are going to be layers to one area of life that experiences a revolution. And this ultimately will help us to tap into, to understand, and to express our most authentic self and whom it is that we were always meant to be, but just didn't know it until we got there and we had to demonstrate it and we had to own what it was that we felt and to acknowledge what it was that becomes clear to us in the moment of clarity. You can't know what you don't know before you know it. But I do think that life has a way of conspiring to help us to become more aware and ultimately to help us to become the most authentic versions of ourselves. And that is worth a party. however your party is, however grand it is, I hope that you find it. And I might do something online somewhere as well. So be on the lookout for that. Now, the other big energy this week is what I am calling Neptunian energy. And so there's this energy in the air that's very creative, very compassionate, but it can also be decidedly ungrounded. But that's also where the saving grace is. Just when we feel like we are lost in feeling or illusion, we are brought back to a more practical understanding. Just when we feel like all that matters is what we feel, we realize that it also matters what it is that we demonstrate. It starts with Mercury retrograde. Right around Tuesday is when Mercury will officially go retrograde in the sign of Pisces. We had to get here, right? So here we are again. This retrograde will last about 3 weeks, and it isn't going to be until we get into the middle of April that Mercury will leave shadow. So that's when the Mercury retrograde season will officially be over. But it really is over the next 3 weeks, and especially with a week like this, that we will feel that much more that something is a little wonky where it comes to communications of all kinds, technologies, and travel as well. Especially short distance travel, you want to be sure to give yourself that little bit of time. But this is happening in the sign of Pisces, and the sign of Pisces is very much about what it is that you feel. It's about spiritual meaning that we give to our events in our life, and feeling a sense of connection, even communion to each other, to everyone, to everything. When Mercury goes retrograde in this part of the sky, it becomes a little bit difficult to distinguish between where it is that it might be our own fears, our own desires, our own hopes, which are beautiful things. They have a way of coloring our experience through life. And especially where it is that we're choosing to see things more optimistically, I think that this can work to our advantage. However, there's the flip side to that as well, which is that we are seeing things in a way that maybe is not being viewed as optimistically as we deserve to see them. That we are considering our circumstances or a moment with too much of an emotional lens, rather than giving it the healthy detachment that it deserves. Having detachment, especially on a mind level, becomes very difficult when Mercury moves through the sign of Pisces. However, there are some really great ways to use this energy. This energy can be very imaginative. And so if you are a writer of any kind, if you are an artist, a musician, if you use your creativity to your advantage, if you think about your creativity as in some way connecting or communing with your creator, that's where you start tapping into the higher potential of this time. You know, I'm reminded of some Sufi philosophy, Sufi mysticism. And as part of that tradition, one of the philosophical assertions of that tradition is that in order to know the creator, you have to create. And so there are different methods and ways in which creation is approached, meaning creative endeavors are approached. This can include poetry, right? We think about the best-selling poet of all time is a Sufi poet, Rumi. We think about music as well, dance, movement. So there are many different ways in which this creative energy can be expressed. But part of it does involve almost like getting lost in the act of creation and the act of creating in order to know the creator. And that necessarily does involve altering our state of consciousness. Now, there are also different ways to do that as well. Our concentration, our complete focus on the creative endeavor that is in front of us to do. Our complete focus on, for example, if you're listening to music or you are creating music or participating in the performance of music, there absolutely is a way to get lost in the sounds that you hear. And where it is that those sounds take you. With a sky like this, it can be a very deeply moving time to appreciate the art in your life, including the musical arts. So that's one way that we can alter consciousness. And then there are some other ways as well that have been used by Sufi mystics over the centuries, including sleep deprivation And for some, even substances as well can be part of the picture. For some, maybe not so much. Maybe the sleep deprivation is enough. Or maybe the creating, the artistic expression, the plugging into source and allowing what needs to come forward from that place is enough of a high to actually alter consciousness so that we can sort of lose ourselves to know ourselves, as Rumi would say, to paraphrase Rumi. So we can sort of get our ego out of the way, get our inhibitions out of the way to truly allow ourselves to immerse in an energy that can be understood as divine, or an energy that can be understood as permeating everyone and everything as part of the collective. And so these types of endeavors, that much more easier when Mercury goes retrograde in the sign of Pisces. However, for most of us, we sort of live in between worlds, if you will. It is the path of the modern mystic to, on the one hand, want to keep that sense of a sensitivity to our environment, to each other, so that we have compassion as we move through the world, we have empathy, but also that we're sensitive enough so that we can access a more spiritual state, a more creative state. However, at the same time, we have to function, right? We can't just sit there and be a sponge. We have to be able to move through our lives and move through the more mundane aspects of our experience in this incarnation. And that can be a little tricky when we've got this kind of energy. And it isn't just about the Mercury retrograde in Pisces, although that is a big part of it. We've also got a new moon the next day after Mercury goes retrograde. And this new moon is also happening in the sign of Pisces, happening hand in hand with Neptune. As we get late into the week, right around Friday, the sun will meet Neptune in the sky as well. So that will be energy we feel growing and magnifying that much more the further we move into the week. And that is only going to heighten these themes that I mentioned, where on the one hand, it's inspiration. On the other hand, it is illusion and disillusionment. On the one hand, it can be feeling like we are high on life. And on the other, it can just feel like not only is there a high, but there's also a low, because for every high, there is a low. And that may be part of the energy that we end up accessing. There can be a feeling of being healed, but then there can also be a feeling of our fears being very much on the surface. The saving grace this week is going to be a harmonious connection from Saturn to the new moon and Saturn to the sun at the very end of the week. That to me says that just as we feel like we're getting lost in emotion or feeling or even uncertainty, which can be part of this energy, we are made grounded thanks to our own effort. And that effort can be however small. It can be reaching out to speak with someone, to communicate with someone. With Saturn, we are reminded to look at the evidence. We are reminded to look at what is being demonstrated to us, not just what we feel or what's being promised to us, or what the possibility is or what the potential is, but what is it that we are actually seeing and we are actually living? And what is it that others are showing us about themselves beyond just what it is that we are hoping for from them? What is it that a particular opportunity could be based on the more practical steps that have been taken to move towards that opportunity rather than just what we hope for? Hoping for a magical turnaround, well, that's one thing, and it does happen sometimes. We do have a sky that does promise that. However, with this sky, it's saying, bring in active practicality, bring in action, you know, take some tangible step, however small. And that in turn will ensure that you are using this energy to its best potential, which ultimately is to take what otherwise would just be a hope and turn it into a lived magical experience. Now, it is when we look at magical experiences as an escape that we start accessing a part of this energy that maybe isn't as healthy. It is very human to hope for, to pray for a magical turn of events that will transform our experience for the better. And there are times when that happens, when lucky breaks do strike. However, more often than not, what does happen is an invitation to actually create magic right where we are, to transform our circumstances through our awareness and through our work. The great potential of this time and the great elation of this time is that we are able to see a vision that is inspired, that is blessed, that does come from a place within us that is divine. And when it is good, when it is guided by love and wisdom, we know that we can trust it. And when we act on it, well, that is when magic and miracles become embodied and they become part of our lived experience. Well, thank you so much for watching. What do you love about this week? What are you looking forward to? What are you excited about? Let me know in the comments below. I absolutely love reading you guys. And of course, if you want to know how all this wonderful stuff this week speaks to you in your sign, you can log on to nadiashaw.com, sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded, exclusive videoscopes every single week, unlimited access to special horoscopes and more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. Please do visit the link in the description below for our sponsor for this video, Ka Gold Jewelry. They make incredible astrology talismans and spiritual amulets from around the world, many different spiritual traditions. I'm sure that you'll be able to find something there that feels inspiring. And even if it's just to look at all the incredibly beautiful artistic work that is there, I would invite you to have a look at that website in the description below. I am now in the middle of the current session of Synchronicity University. Thank you so much to the students who joined me for the very first session, which took place earlier today. It was so much fun. It was so rewarding. It was an adventure with Mercury station in the sky, but I really appreciated it. And I know I learned so much. It was this last class that we talked about higher power and defining what higher power is for you based on the astrology chart. And you can now download that particular class as well as sign up for the other classes that are on offer. Upcoming classes this month, live classes online, include transforming difficult relationships, understanding moments of transformation, and cultivating forgiveness, all in the astrology chart. Now, all of the classes as part of this session have been inspired by some of the amazing people that I met while I recently had some live events in Las Vegas and in Mexico, where I came to realize that, you know, we have some very important transits happening, celestial events happening this year and next year as well. And there's a lot of focus being paid on next year. Yes, it is a time of change, but this year is also. And I feel like these classes, I really do believe in them, because I do feel like they are going to help a lot of people, whether it is you understanding your own chart or whether it is that you help other people by understanding them and their charts more deeply and being able to guide them as a result of what you learn in these classes. So I do hope that they are particularly rewarding. I do have a lot of live events coming up as well. The most notable live event I have coming up is in January 2020, under the light of the Saturn-Pluto conjunction, carrying forward the same theme of love, joy, hope, and transformation. I'm bringing that to a cruise event. I am one of many speakers that is part of this wonderful, life-changing, transformative event that is going to take place on the allure of the seas. And so that is going to be quite the adventure. Please do have a look at the link in the description below. That will take you to a page on my website that will give you a lot more details. There's also an event on my Facebook page as well. And so if you sign up for notifications there, you'll be kept up to date on all the different happenings, the schedule, and also information on how it is that you can sign up and join us there. Be out of your comfort zone, be in the middle of the ocean with some of the most notable astrologers in the world today, and have a chance to understand something about ourselves and about navigating this very important time of transition for the collective. In-person events also include in May, I will be in Vancouver and in Seattle. And Labor Day weekend, I will be in Baltimore. So there's so much to look forward to. And I always look forward to meeting friends and fans in real time, whether that's online or in the physical realm, which is always a very rewarding part of the journey as well. And I want to say thank you. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for your trust and for having me be some small part of your sacred journey. I am really so very grateful for it. And it is this week right now that is going to invite us not to get lost in our fears, to ride any wave of emotion, to feel things deeply, yes, but to use it in some way, to use it to help others, to use it to move ourselves in a direction that feels more inspired. And I do believe very much in this idea of taking magic and translating it into our lived experience and taking what otherwise would just be a fantasy and having it actually manifest in our reality. Well, that requires our participation. And it is going to be this week that invites us to glimpse the mystery, to glimpse the possibility, but then also to take ownership for where it is and how it is that we can move ourselves in that more ideal direction. And I wish you a lot of joy and self-knowledge along that path for this week as you navigate this week ahead. Well, thank you again for watching. It'll be a great week. Enjoy.